Temperature 28. Dew point 11. Altimeter 30.09. Runways in use 03 right 21 left. Expect visual approach. Acknowledge receipt of information tag.
Dusk check-in.
Two's up, 5-5.
One copies.
Pull up. Altitude.
21 left. Expect visual approach. Acknowledge receipt of information Tango and advise aircraft type on first contact. Nellis Air Force Base information Tango, time 1455. Wind 330 at 10. Visibility greater than 10 miles. View 8,000 feet. Temperature 28. Dew point 11. Altimeter 30.09. Runways in use 03 right 21 left. Expect visual approach. Acknowledge receipt of information Tango and advise aircraft type on first contact. Nellis Air Force Base information Tango, time 1455. Wind 330 at 10. Visibility greater than 10 miles. View 8,000 feet. Temperature 28. Dew point 11. Altimeter 30.09. Runways in use 03 right 21 left. Expect visual approach. Acknowledge receipt of information Tango and advise aircraft type on first contact. Nellis Air Force Base information Tango, time 1455. Wind 330 at 10. Visibility greater than 10 miles.
Leeds got a good jet.
Two has a good jet, ready to taxi.
Raj, let me get our clearance and we'll roll. Nellis clearance, Tusk 2 clearance on request, ready to copy.
Tusk 2, clearance expect range entry at Elgin via the A-10 TAC. North departure is filed. Climb and maintain Angel 6. Expect 12,000 10 minutes after departure. Departure on 385.4, squawk 4031.
A-10 TAC North, range entry at Elgin. Climb for 6,000. 12,000 10 minutes after departure. Can I get that squawk again, please, for Tusk 2?
Tusk 2, readback correct. Squawk is 4031.
That's 4031 for Tusk 2. Thanks, guys. Push ground.
Two is up.
Ground, Tusk 2 is 2 A-10s with Tango at the Revits for 03 right.
Tusk 2, Nellis ground. Runway 03 right, taxi via Golf, Alpha. Hold short at Alpha. Tango is current.
Tusk 2, taxi Golf, Alpha, hold short at Alpha. Let's roll.
Most of the time, everything we do is in sim, so actually getting to shoot at some drones
something we get to do very often.
No, not at all. It does happen from time to time, but not too often within the A-10 community.
Roger.
Tusk 2, switch tower, 327.7. So long.
Tusk 2, switching tower. See ya.
Two's up on tower.
Ready for departure?
Yep.
Nellis Tower, Tusk 2, holding 03 right and Alpha, ready for departure.
Tusk 2, tower, winds 330 at 10, cleared for takeoff runway 03 right. Change departure.
Tusk 2, clear for takeoff 03 right. See ya. Let me know when you pass Apex.
Will go. Apex.
Departure. Tusk 2 is passing Apex on the A-10 tack north.
Tusk 2, Nell's departure. Radar contact. Turn left heading 010. Maintain 6,000 until Dry Lake. Contact Blackjack on 377.8.
Left for 010. Maintain 6,000 and switch to Blackjack. Alright, this should be good. Ready to proceed.
You may know, the A-10 has a few air-to-air kills to its credit. In Operation Desert Storm, Captain Swing strafed the PO-105. He was flying 770205. Now on a stick at the U.S. Air Force Academy. According to his account, when the rounds hit the chopper, it looked like he was hit by a bomb. The second kill was against another helicopter and also in Operation Desert Storm. This time it was Captain Sheehy in 810964, shooting down an MI-8 with a gun. Last I knew, 964 is still proudly serving with the 23rd Fighter Wing.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. I've seen both, actually.
Neat. As you can tell from these two instances over the 30-plus year operation, air-to-air is not something that is common for the hog community, but it can certainly happen, so we need to train to it. Despite being designed explicitly for the air-to-ground role, A-10 is definitely not helpless in a dogfight. Ironically, some of the features that make it so great at its air and ground role help against other aircraft. As a matter of fact, there have been many humbled Hornet, Viper, and Eagle pilots, and even a Raptor driver. That big straight wing gives us an amazingly tight turning circle, and there are not too many fixed-wing aircraft that can outrange. Flying against someone who has never fought a hog, you can usually catch them off guard and get the kill if you're quick about it. In the A-10, you're good for about one turn. After that, your energy state is low and it becomes a game of survival until a wingman is gonna help you out.
Copy that.
Like any fight, we're gonna want to try and drive the fight to exploit our strengths in regards to both ourselves and our equipment. Us not having a great deal of thrust at our disposal, trading altitude for knots is something we're probably going to have to do, if we can, to survive. Heading for the deck has the added effect of taking the flight somewhere where we, as A-10 drivers, should feel comfortable and have the advantage. Your average fighter pick is not going to have a great deal of experience down low, and with any luck, he'll fly the damn thing into the ground. After all, a maneuver kill is a kill.
Hell yeah, it is.
The only thing with taking the flight into the weeds is that once we're down there, we're stuck down there. We don't have the thrust to climb away, and once your opponent realizes you can check out with a zoom climb, you're now a sitting duck with nowhere to go.
Yeah, I could see how that could be problematic.
Indeed. Okay, I'll shut up for a while. We'll pick it up when we get to tier 3. coming up to steer 3. Get yourself into an orbit and we'll start to left.
All right, I think I'm happy with this. Go ahead and begin when ready.
Firstly, let's get into air-to-air mode by depressing the master mode control button for more than 1 second. It does not matter what mode you're in, be it nav, CCIP, guns, or CCRP. Pressing it for over a second will go straight to air-to-air mode. Let me know when you're in air-to-air mode.
I'm now in air-to-air mode.
Actually, let's also go ahead and put the master arm into train so we can look at topology without shooting anything for now. Also put the pack switch into the gun arm position too.
Master arm is set to training and gun arm is set as well.
You know what we should have went over first? Disregard, we'll come back to that. Okay, looking at the air-to-air HUD, there is not a whole awful lot of difference between it and the other mode. Basically, all we get with it is the gun aiming symbology, which there is a lot going on there, and the AIM-9 seeker reticle.
Roger.
Below your airspeed in the HUD, you should see MAN 6, just above DTAS mode, and FOM. This indicates that we're currently using manual profile within the air-to-air submenu. With the HUD SOI DMS left and right short, we'll cycle through the active air-to-air submenu profiles. There are 10 default profiles for fixed and rotary winged assets. Additionally, you have two with parameters that are manually set, one for fixed wing and one for rotary. We'll talk about that a bit more in a minute. For now, just go ahead and cycle through the profiles and note how the funnel changes a bit with each one.
Alright, I'm happy with that.
Let's get you slotted in behind me here. I think it might make the next bit a little easier. Drop back on my 6, maybe a quarter mile to a half mile behind me. And when you're set up and happy, let me know and we'll move on.
Check 6.
I see you back there. One more thing before we go any further. Please, for the love of God, make sure you're in train and not armed on that master arm switch, please.
Master arm verified, set to train.
Alright, let's have a look at gun-related symbology a little bit more in depth. The gun funnel is the most obvious part of this. The purpose of the funnel is to help you in lining up a gun shot. It does this by taking into account the targets you've held, like airspeed, wingspan, and your aircraft's maneuver. Using the correct AES profile is going to be critical for a gun kill. If you're trying to gun an F5 but you're using a profile for an A10, you're going to have a bad time. Since the F5's wingspan is less than half of the much lead if you line him up in the funnel and shot, which happens to be a pretty good segue into how to use the funnel.
Don't you mean MiG-28?
Maybe. It's classified. Using the funnel is really easy. Once you've expertly maneuvered your A-10 behind that MiG-28, maybe using a 4G negative dive, exploiting that weakness with its inverted flight tank.
Rumor has it they can do a negative G pushover, actually.
Alright, let's dial it in.
Sorry, it's hard to put that horse back in the barn.
Understandable. Okay, so using the funnel is as easy as getting behind the bandit and going so that the target's wingtip just touches the inside of the funnel.
Sounds pretty easy.
In theory it is, but there are some considerations. Firstly, in the A-10, we don't have a radar backing us up to provide a no-shit, dead-on aiming solution. So even when used properly, the funnel is still the best guess. Because of this, it is advisable to fire a 1 second burst and range target with force by either starting to shoot out in front of the target and relaxing the G so that it flies up the funnel, or start behind the target and pull harder to bring it down the funnel. Also, when shooting air-to-air, we turn tack off so we get more bullet dispersion to effectively shotgun the target.
That is smart.
Definitely. The next part of the gun symbology is the air mass impact line, or A-mill. The A-mill is a solid line that extends downward toward the ground near the top of the HUD. The A-mill shows your bullet drop from just out of the muzzle of the gun to 2 seconds time of flight. Even though the 30 by 173 millimeter has excellent ballistics, you'll have to deal with aerodynamic drag and gravity.
Roger.
Just like in the air-to-ground mode, we have the gun or line at the top of the HUD. Got the difference there. So the last thing gun-specific we'll talk about here is MRTS line to the bottom of the HUD. The multiple reference gun sight lines are the 5 centrally collapsing lines at the bottom of a HUD in an arc. The MRTS lines help you pull the correct amount of lead when at medium aspect angle.
To expand on that a bit?
Sure. So for approaching a bandit head-on at high aspect, or from behind, low aspect, our gun funnel will do a good job of lining up that shot. However, it's not well suited for medium aspect. The MRGS lines will help position ourselves for a good tracking gunshot. We discussed how the funnel uses the target's wingspan to line up a valid shot. Well, the MRGS lines are going to be against the target's fuselage. What we're going to want to do is position ourselves so that the length of one of those MRTS lines is equal to the length of the target's fuselage. If the target is larger than the line, we're pulling too much lead and we need to relax the G to create some distance. If the target is smaller, we'll need to pour more lead to get into the right position. Keeping the band's fuselage equal to the length of the line will help you walk around the circle and arrive at a good range and position to transition back to the gun funnel for a shot.
So the MRGS lines are not used for targeting, just to help you get into position for a shot, yeah?
That is correct. Before we move into the AIM-9 stuff, let's go through setting up a manual profile within the air-to-air submenu, or AAS, real quick.
Sounds good. Let's do it.
Alright, put the IF key into test, then scroll down and select AAS. Are you now looking at the AAS?
Affirm.
Alright, so we can see all the standard profiles, but notice there's not one for say you're mid-28, so we'll make one. Scroll down to Man Fix for manual fixing and select it by pressing Enter on the USB. Now build the manual profile for the F5. Sorry, MiG-28. As you can see, we can input values for the wingspan, fuselage length, and airspeed. While we know the target's wingspan, the airspeed is going to change, so give it your best guess. If memory serves, the F5 has a 25-foot wingspan that is like 47 feet in length. We'll say with that small wing, it'll be at about 275 knots. Go ahead and put all that into the AAS. You're going to need to select the line you wish to change, then use the data rocker on the USB to adjust the value.
Alright, 25-foot wingspan, 47 feet long, and 275 knots all inputted.
Great, scroll down to Store and hit Enter. This should take us back to the AAS profile page. Let's pop down and look at the Man Rotary profile real quick.
Alright, I have the manual rotary profile open.
Perfect. Notice how we do not have an option for target speed, and here wingspan is replaced by diameter of the rotor disc. It says rotary wingspan, but it implies the disc diameter.
Noted.
Great. Head back out to the AAS menu and I'll show you how to activate and deactivate profiles.
Okay, back looking at the profile page.
Good deal. The active profiles are those that have a circle off their left side. Go ahead and deactivate everything other than A10, SU-25, and the Man 6 profiles for complete. To do this, simply move the pointer wheel next to the profile and hit Enter on the USB.
the frog foot and my manual fixed wing profiles are all active. All the others are off. Except for the manual rotary. I can't turn that off.
Yep, I forgot you can't disable either of the manual profiles. Nonetheless, hit exit and put the IFC back into on, and then scroll through your AAS profiles as you did before. Now, when you scroll, you should only see the profiles we left active and not all the others.
All right, I see what you're talking about.
Now, I want you to maneuver me into the reticle again, and this time hit China Hat forward short. This will uncage the seeker. With me within the seeker's field of view, the seeker should snap to my aircraft and lock me up. You will hear the lock sound. Do this now and let me know when you have me locked up.
I've got tone. Good luck.
Nice. Moving on. Hit TMSF short to break lock and re-gauge that seeker. Next, we'll look at the plume of the seeker to the target and the circular scan pattern.
Sounds great. Ready when you are.
Alright, I want you to maneuver so that my jet is out of the HUD and just above it. Once you've done that, we'll look at the circular scan and the self-track mode.
I've got you just above the HUD.
Great. Hit TMS forward short once for me to get into circular scan. Verify you see the seeker reticle moving in a circular movement. Also, if you run into any issues with the seeker from here on, it's a good habit to just re-cage it and try it again. To re-cage the seeker back to port site, hit TMS aft.
Reticle is moving in a circular pattern in the HUD now.
Great. Now that the seeker is in circular scan and you have given it consent to self-track, whenever you place me back into the AM-9 scan zone and it sees me, it will automatically lock onto my aircraft. Go ahead and give that a try once or twice. After you've locked me up, it is still TMS aft short or China Hat aft short for brake lock.
Seems like a pretty easy operation. I've managed to get it to work, and I'm ready to move on.
Great, let's move on to manual flume mode now.
Alright, I'm ready.
With manual flume, you're going to have to move the seeker around via the seat. It's a pretty simple operation. With the HUD stowed, just drive the reticle to the target via the DDC. When the seeker gets near a valid automatically lock onto that source. Hitting China Hat or TMS aft short will break that lock and re-gauge the reticle. Give that a quick try for me and let me know when you're ready to press.
No problems there. Let's move on.
Sweet! There is one other method to get the AM-9 onto a target, and that's using the targeting pod. So, we'll have a quick look at the pod's air-to-air mode, then how to use it with the AM-9. Get the pod spun up and in air-to-air mode. Once you're ready, let me know, and we'll talk about it.
All right, the pod is on and in air-to-air mode.
There's not much to the pod's air-to-air mode. The host has commands that are the same as the air-to-ground mode. When you enter air-to-air, your pod will be four-sided looking at the gun four line. Simply steer your jet to get it on target or move the pod towards it. Note that while in air-to-air mode, your TV will still have all the same field of view, zoom, and the IR function. As the air to ground mode has, but there will be no indication where the pod is looking, unlike in air to ground. You're going to want to put the target inside of the four filter you track. When this happens, you'll see break at the bottom of the TTP page and across your own target air track. A quick press of TMS forward short will command a point track on the aircraft indicated by the pod entering the target in the middle of the display. Track and cross over it and range to the point at the bottom of the MSC. From here, sway the HUD and press China hat forward long to slave the AIM-9 to the track.
That sounds highly efficient.
To be honest, I'm glad it's a feature we have and it would move us to train to it, but I think that 98% of the time it's going to be quicker and easier to padlock the cluster, put him on the nose, old-fashioned lock way past these two back in the day.
Agreed.
I'm glad you do. So, with that said, let's give this process a try. If you'd like to adjust your position to give yourself more room to work, feel free to do so. It's actually easier to do this than the 2 miles between you and the desired target. Just give me a heads up when you're ready to proceed.
I'm ready.
Pod in air-to-air mode, get a TTP track on the target by slowing the pod so that the target flies through the field of view bracket. When it does this, press TMS forward short once to point track on it. You very well may need to try this a few times. If you've got the point track on it, let me know and we'll move on to the next part of the process.
Track.
Kick ass. Now that we've got a good track, trying to have forward long to slave the AIM-9 through the pod. When it does this, it will also lock the target if it's within gimbal limits. Listen for that lock sound. From here, just hit pickle and the missile will be on its way.
Roger.
If for some reason you need to recage the AIM-9 or really do anything to it, HOTAS related after you slave the seeker, you're gonna have to re-soy the HUD to do so.
That makes sense.
I think that will just about cover all the AIM-9 things aside from missile rejection. It's not super uncommon to have issues with caps, things like no tone or one little hell, we fly the piss out of them. Hopefully, the lives will be a little more dependable if we ever need them. Regardless, we have capability to reject a missile and step to the next one if we have a problem getting one to work. If you reject your missile, hit China hat aft short twice. Again, hitting it once recages the seeker, the second press will remove it from service. If you accidentally hit China hat aft twice and did not mean to remove a missile from service, have no fear. Continue rejecting missiles. Once all of your missiles are rejected, they will all be returned to active status instead.
Roger.
With that, let's start putting some of this to use. Let's start by getting you to employ simulated sidewinders on.
I have waited so long.
I said simulated, so don't get too excited. All right, Kermit, the very first thing I want you to do is make damn sure that master arm is in training. Please do that for me.
Master arm set to train.
Good. Gun pack down in the gun arm position.
Gun arm. Dust 2-1, Fox 2.
Good. Now go to circular scan and shoot the second one.
Dust 2-1, Fox 2.
A few considerations with the winder. Even though the 9 mic is all aspect, it is always going to have the best chance with a tail-on shot. Of the hot engine exhaust. Also, even though it does have flare rejection, it will still bite off on this given the right circumstances. As a general rule, the less time the missile is in the air, the higher the PK will be. That really is a balancing act, though. You don't really want to launch it out there at the bleeding edge of its range and give the guy enough time to drop the throttle, cool the engine, dump out a bucket of flare, and put himself between the missile and the sun. At the other end of the spectrum, you don't want to be so close that the missile does not have time to maneuver, or you wind up flying through a ball of sheet metal and rivet.
Speaking of range, I'm assuming we can range with the pod, but is there anything new in the Charlie to feed us that info?
Correct. There's nothing in the jet that gives us ranging information in the HUD or otherwise. The pod can give us range data, but you'll need to pick up the contact and air to ground, and get a point track on it. And late, which as you can tell is going to be problematic in most, if not all, cases. The best thing I can tell you is you're going to have to estimate the range and clock to when you're within range and all that.
Roger that.
To cap that off, we typically like to shoot the missile between 1/2 and 2 miles. Also, when you do shoot it, try to pull a little lead so that the missile has to maneuver less, thus leave less energy to get to the target. Subject to the gal, let's quickly talk about feds, then work on your aerial gunnery. So the firing evaluation display system, or FED, is going to give you several pairs of dots that are spaced as wide as the target's wingspan along the board's trajectory. The dots start at a time of flight of 0.18 seconds and range up to 2 seconds. FEDs will display in the HUD as long as the trigger is suppressed.
What? That's it?
Well, as the statement implies, it's a system for evaluation. After you shoot today, we'll review your tape. Part of that is going to be reviewing your gunnery. We'll use FEDs for that review and evaluation. It's a debrief, that's all.
Okay.
Yep. Okay, now I want you to go in for a good gunshot.
Roger. Going in for guns.
As you close in, try to get into a good offensive position, the control zone. Stabilize as the situation permits, and go for that sweet, zen-like gun skill.
Roger. 1, guns, guns, guns.
Good deal. Are you ready for the real thing? Or do you want to practice some more in training mode?
I'm ready to go now. Let's roll.
We ride north.
Blackjack, Tusk 2, leaving Elgin for Callion 2, Charlie.
Tusk 2, Blackjack copies. Contact Whetstone on 317.450. Good day.
Whetstone, 317.45, Tusk 2.
2-0.
Whetstone, Tusk 2 with you, leaving Elgin for Callion 2, Charlie.
Tusk 2, Whetstone, good to have you. Charlie, you're worn in, orbiting as fragged. Darkstar has picture, Whetstone has control. Squawk 4077 and IDEX.
Whetstone with control, squawk 4077.
Overlord 1-1, Bra 035440 at 15,000, flanking.
Tusk 2 with the flash.
Tusk 2, radar contact. Proceed to IP cores, maintain Angels 12, report tally on the drone. First drone will be guns.
Head to IP cores at 12,000 and we'll report when visual for the gunshot.
Visual friendly, tally enemy.
What?
Call tally for enemy, not visual.
Point taken.
Also, before we get there, re-enable the F-16 profile in the air-to-air submenu. You remember how it was done, right?
Tusk 2-1, Overlord 1-1, Bra 035440 at 15,000, flanking.
Afer, good point. Alright, Biff. Where is this guy gonna be?
He should be up near Tier 4 at 15,000. If you're not able to find them, feel free to call Darkstar on 114.500 and get Bra from them.
Tusk 2-1, Overlord 1-1, Bra 033430 at 15,000, flanking.
1, overlord 1-1, bra 034, 429, at 15,000, flanking. hot.
One's visual, F-16.
Don't tell me it's all westbound. Because when you do, it's tally, not visual.
Tusk
remember,
two, one,
target,
one,
not
one,
Dennis and Moody flying
VFR.
Also,
do
you remember to put your master arm in arm position?
Westbound, Tusk 2-1 is tally, F-16.
Tusk 2-1, westbound, roger. Clear to hide on that target with guns.
Tusk 2-1, in with the gun. Tusk 2-1, guns, guns, guns.
Hell yeah, man, nice shooting.
Whetstone, Tusk 2-1, splash start.
Tusk 2-1, copy. Push for Budweiser. Maintain Angels 12, report wind tally.
Tusk 2, pushing for IP Budweiser. Angels 12, will report tally.
Alright, this guy should be defensive, so expect him to try and deny you a missile shot. Try and time the shot so that you're shooting in between him dispensing a bunch of flares.
Sounds like a party.
Should be fun.
Tusk 2-1, Overlord 1-1, Bra 263-421 at 16,000 knots. Tusk 2-1, Overlord 1-1, Bra 267-418 at 16,000 cold. 1, Overlord 1-1, Bra 256, 412, at 16,000, hot. Tusk 2-1, Overlord 1-1, Bra 249-45 at 16,000, flanking.
Tusk 2-1, Tally Pipe, Overlord 1-1,
merged.
Tusk 2-1, Raj, stand by for launch authorization in 3 seconds.
Tusk 2-1, standing by for the shot. Fox 2, Viper.
Good kill.
Whetstone, Tusk 2-1, splash target.
Tusk 2-1, roger, you are cleared to RTB.
Whetstone, Tusk 2-1 is RTB at this time. Blackjack, Tusk 2-1 is with you just off Budweiser, RTB.
Tusk 2, Blackjack, climb and maintain Angels 15, fly direct Moapa, contact Nellis approach now, 291.725, good day.
Climb and maintain Angels 15, direct Moapa, and contact approach for Tusk 2, see ya. Approach Tusk 2 with you, climbing for 15,000 direct Moapa, looking for visual stop 2-1 left.
Tusk 2, Nellis approach. Roger, continue direct Moapa, expect visual 2-1 left, squawk 4031 and Iden.
And Tusk with the flash.
Tusk 2, radar contact.
Tusk 2, fence out.
confirm you wanted a straight in for 2-1 left.
A-firm, straight in stop for Tusk 2.
Tusk 2-1, roger. Cleared visual 2-1 left.
Tusk 2-1 is clear for the visual for 2-1 left, thanks.
Tusk 2-2, proceed to Apex and give me a right-hand orbit.
Right-hand orbit over Apex, Tusk 2-2.
Thank you. Tusk 2-1, contact Nellis Tower 327 decimal set.
327.7, Tusk 2-1, see ya. Nellis Tower, Tusk 2-1, visual left, stop.
Tusk 2-1, Nellis Tower. Winds 330 for 10, confirm gear, clear to land, runway 21 left.
Tusk 2-1, 3 green, clear to land on the left.
Altitude. Thank you.
21, clear at Alpha, contact ground 275.8. Tusk 22, Nellis Tower, winds 330 for 10, confirm gear, clear to land runway 21 left. Tusk 22, Nellis Tower, cleared visual runway 21 left.
Tusk 22, you're clear to land 21 left. Cleared visual 21 left. Tusk